So today's tutorial is on local business listing, how we can list our business on different local business listing sites or local directory websites, and how we can create a structured map citation, and how we can get a link back to our site from those local business listing websites. Some of the examples can be maybe Yelp.com, Y-E-L-P. Yelp.com is an international local business listing site. There can be sites like JustDial.com from India. There can be sites like maybe IndiaMART or Trade India. All those are business listing sites. So if you have a business, you can list your business information on these websites, and you can create a map citation, name, address, phone number. That is very important for local search engine optimization. You can create your map citation, structured map citation on local directories. And as well as you can create a link for your website. So those are the different benefits we are going to we can get from local directory websites. And these are local directory websites. These are not web directories. Like we already did tutorials on maybe on demos.org or different other web directory websites. So those are web directories, and these JustDial or Yelp or Silex or Trade India, those are actually business directory websites, local business directory websites. So this type of websites help in two ways. This will help you in local search engine optimization because you will be able to create your structured map citation here. And as well as if you can get a link from these websites to your website, then that will help you in normal search engine optimization, organic ranking. So those are the two different things I'm going to show here on local directory tutorial. So I'm going to show two different websites. First, I will show you JustDial.com. It's a good website from India. And I will show another website, Silex. So let's move here. I'm having this list. So there are lots of local business listing sites here. So you can use this list. So I'm moving to JustDial.com. I need to go to first Google. Then I need to go to Open Site Explorer. I'm searching with JustDial.com. It must come on the first organic ranking. So it's coming on organic ranking. Site is opening with www. And you can see their knowledge graph. This is called a knowledge graph. You must have a Wikipedia page to come here. So JustDial has a Wikipedia page, and this is their knowledge graph with all social links, their founder name, and all the details. So now, as you can see, this site is coming on the first position with www. You move to Open Site Explorer, search with this domain, and check the domain authority and spam score. It should be something more 440. 40 should be minimum domain authority. Spam score can be maximum 4 as usual. So here we have 62 domain authority out of 100 and 2 spam score out of 17. So site is good. We can go and build our link and citation here. So I'm moving to JustDial.com. If you open JustDial.com here, you will see this site. And the primary objective of using this type of sites are two. I want to create a map citation, structured map for my business, as well as I want to create a link back to my website. So now, if you move to any of these sites, you will always see a link like free listing or submit your business or add your business or maybe add your link, something like that. So that may be at the top of the page or at the left side or at the right side or maybe at the bottom of the page. Somewhere you will see a link like this, free listing or something. So you just have to browse the page and you will be able to see that. So here we have two different options. At the top, free listing, and at the bottom there was another free listing link. So click here on free listing. And you will be taken to the next page where you have to put the business name information. So I'm moving to the next page and list your business for free with India's leading search engine. So say for there is a company called Clean Master. Clean Master is a company from India, from maybe Delhi, and they are into cleaning business. So maybe that is my own business, or that may be my client's business. So I want to register their business information on JustDial. So how to do that? It's very simple, similar to GMB, Google My Business. You have to put the company name. Don't put anything other than the company name. Don't put any keyword here. The same name which you have mentioned on Google My Business, exactly same thing you have to put here. The NAP information cannot be different. Name, address, phone number of the business which you have mentioned on GMB, it should be exactly same everywhere on internet. That can be JustDial, that can be Trade India, IndiaMart, Yelp, Silex, wherever it is, or maybe Foursquare, wherever it is, the NAP information should be 100% consistent and same. That is the critical thing. You have to maintain it. Otherwise, your local SEO won't be possible. So if you have a business called Clean Master, you have to use the same thing here. So maybe I have used Clean Master name on Google My Business, so I will use the same Clean Master here. So if you can remember the Google My Business tutorial, I told you that if you are getting the NAP information, you used to get the NAP information directly from GMB. Google My Business used to show you the NAP in one place. I told you to copy that, paste it on a notepad and save it on your project folder. So whenever you are doing a NAP citation, when you are building a NAP citation, open that notepad. Don't try to type anything. Copy the NAP. Copy the name from that notepad, paste it here. That is very important. Second, these informations are not present on GMB, name, first name, last name. So you can put anything, there is no problem. So say for I'm putting, Suraj, and last name is say for Sharma. Next, maybe mobile number. Put the same mobile number which you have mentioned on GMB. Again, do not type anything. Copy the phone number from your notepad, paste it here. So say for the phone number is this. Next one is city. City again, which what city you have mentioned on GMB, same city you have to mention here. So say for that is Delhi. So Delhi is here. You can select Delhi from the list. So these are the things you have to do. You can select say for Mr. here. So this is the company name. I have mentioned the same company name on GMB. This is a person's name. So it was not available on GMB. So I can put anything here. Phone number. Again, the phone number is an important part of NAP. Name, address, phone number. So we have to mention the exactly same phone number which we have already mentioned on GMB. And Delhi. This is the city of the business, so we have mentioned Delhi on GMB also, so we are mentioning the same here. If you need to add another phone number, you have this option. You can click here, and another mobile number you can input here, which is not recommended. I told you the same thing on GMB also. If you go to the GMB tutorial, you would see that I told there that put one phone number on GMB, and the same phone number you should put here. Don't put any alternate phone number, that is not required. Clean Master company, this is phone number, this is the city. Next, you click here on submit. Once you click here on submit, you will be taken to the next page, and company name matches with brand name. Click OK to proceed. So no problem, we can move. There can be two different companies with the same name. There is no problem with that. And means as long as their address and phone number is different, there is no problem. NAP should be in combination. NAP should be different for two different companies. There can be two different companies with same name. There can be two different companies with same address. There can be two different companies with same phone number. That is possible. If you are using a toll-free number, or if you are using a maybe software number, then there can be multiple companies who can share the same phone number. Maybe company 1, company 2, company 3 is sharing the same phone number. If somebody calls to that number and they want to go to company 2, the receptionist or the caller will receive the call, and they will put some extension and they will forward the call to the company 2. That is how this works. So there can be multiple companies with same name. There can be multiple companies on the same address. There can be multiple companies with the same phone number. But in combination, NAP cannot be same for two companies. That is not possible. If there are two companies with same name, same address, same phone number, then those are actually not two companies, those are same company. So there can be, as I told, there can be two companies with same name, but that is absolutely possible as long as their address and phone numbers are different. So here CleanMaster company is my client, and I mentioned their name here. Next one is building. So if you can remember, on GMB we had a street address, and after that there was a small link after that street address option, and add a line. I told you, click on that add a line and put all your building information there. So that particular information you have to put here. So say for this particular business is on maybe Techno Plaza building, and they are on floor, or maybe third floor, room 301, and the street address is say for MG Road. So these are the thing you have done already on GMB. You do not type anything, copy all the details from your notepad and paste it here. Landmark area, you can put the area also, there is no problem with area. You can, or you may just skip this, as it is actually not present on GMB, so you can skip this. Landmark should not be posted here. Area may or may not be, landmark should not be posted. Remember this, because if you put the landmark option is not there on GMB. If you put landmark information here, your NAP citation would be different from GMB NAP. So that is not acceptable. So don't put landmark here. City Delhi is selected. Select a pin code from here. Say for you mentioned this pin code on GMB. So select this here. State is Delhi. Country is India. Next, you click here on save and continue. Let's see if they ask for the area location. Save and continue. Company name matches with brand. Click OK to proceed ahead. There is no problem with the company name. So they are taking me to the next page. Next, I have to put the landline number here. That is not required because I have already mentioned the phone number, mobile number. So if you have mentioned a landline number on GMB, landline numbers are trusted more than phone mobile numbers. Means Google trusts landline numbers more than phone mobile numbers. So if you have a mobile landline number for your business, you should put the landline number on GMB. That is recommended, but there can be a problem with that. Means maybe your landline number is dead. In that case, you have to put another alternate phone number on GMB. So you can just skip that. You put the mobile number on GMB. That is means working good today. There is no problem right now. So I have put the same mobile number here. So I'm not going to put any landline number here, because if I put landline number here, my NAP will be different. That is, I do not want. So put the same phone number on which you have mentioned on GMB. Same here on Just Dial. Once you are done here, you have to just put the email ID. See, email ID is not a part of NAP. So you can put your company email ID here. So maybe info@ cleanmaster.in. This can be a company in email ID. Always go for the company email ID. That is good. Means that will be verified automatically. So never put your Gmail or Yahoo or Outlook mail IDs. Those are unprofessional and does not look good. So this is my email ID. Again, I can build a link from here. So always remember, you have to put the same version. If your site is opening with HTTP, put HTTP, or else https://. If your site is opening with www dot, mention that. If your site is opening non-W version, don't mention www. And then cleanmaster.in. So this is the website. This is the email ID. This is the phone number. Rest of the details we may or may not put. That is not important. Next, we have next option, save and continue. Click here. So now you can see we had the same similar operational hours option on GMB. So first we have to click here, display operation hours of operations. Click here. This is now editable. I can edit this right now. So we have to mention the same operational hours which we have already mentioned on GMB. It cannot be different. So say for on GMB you have mentioned from Monday to Friday you are working from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. So you have to select the same 10 in the morning. This is 10 in the morning and 6 means 18. So we have to select 18 here. So this is the thing we are doing for Monday and Friday. So copy the timings from Monday to Saturday. Select this. It will be done here. So now on Sunday if you are closed, mark this closed. And if Saturday you are working from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. which you have already mentioned on GMB, you can do the same here. 10 and you can make it 14. So it will be done. 10 to 14. So Monday to Friday we are working from 10 to 6. Saturday we are working from 10 to 2 and Sunday we are closed. Same thing we mentioned on GMB. So this is how we have to put the operational hours. Next, payment models accepted by you. See, these informations are not available on GMB. So we can select anything. There is no problem. We can select cash, debit cards, credit cards, checks, Visa card, MasterCard. So all those are maybe these are all possible Hello. Options.
No voice.
And next one is company information. You can put all those information. There is no problem because GMB does not have these options. So you can put anything here. There is no problem. Year of establishment, maybe annual turnover, select number of employees, professional associations. If you are associated with any chamber of commerce or maybe any governing authority, you can put all the names here. If you have received a certification or maybe you are ISO certified or INC certified, Six Sigma certified, so you can put all those information here. So these are the things actually not important because this may fill all the information on JustDial, but this does not have anything to do with your local SEO or your normal regular SEO. But whatever we have on GMB, if you see the same thing present on another website, you have to put all the same information. So once you are done here, you go to click on save and continue, and you will be taken to the next page. We are moving to the next page, and here we have to select keywords. So business keywords, this is the first thing you have to select here. Maybe add more keywords option. You can click here and you will be taken to this page where you have to select the keywords. So you can see there is an option to search keyword. So say for this business is on cleaning business. So you can see you can type with clean and if there is any, you can see cleaning services there, cleaning service for car interior. Definitely it's not going right. We are into home cleaning business. So cleaning services would be fine, cleaning services and all those are fine. These are all fine for cleaning services. So let me select cleaning services first. And we can select this, and there are different cleaning services options. Cleaning services is the broader category, and under that there can be lots of subcategories. So you can select all those: sofa, carpet, cleaning services, corporate, cleaning services for industries, housekeeping. Housekeeping can be, may or may not be selected depending on your business type. Floor cleaning, office chair cleaning, all those can be selected. If that is relevant with your business, you can select that keyword. So we can select one by one all those stuffs. We are not going to select all those. You can select, there is no problem. 170 records are found for cleaning services. Whatever is coming relevant with your business, you can select that. Finally, once you are done here, you have to click here on save and continue. So click on save and continue. These keywords does not have anything to do with your search engine optimization. It only works on JustDial. So you can select a couple of keywords, that's going to be fine. So we have selected 17 business keywords here. If you need to add more, you have to click here on add more keywords link, and you will be taken to the previous page where you can select more keywords from the list. And finally, you have to click here on save and continue. If you click here on save and continue, you will be taken to the next page. And Here you can see they are asking you for the verification. You just need to verify your listing now and it will be live on justdial.com. The verification SMS will be sent on the mobile number. So once I click on this button, one verification code I will receive on the phone number which I have mentioned, and I have to put that phone number. Say for I'm clicking here, once I click here I would receive the PIN means verification number. I have to put that verification number here and I have to click on verify. Once I do this, my business listing will be verified and it will be live on justdial.com. So instantly I will be able to get a link and I'll be able to get a NAP citation. This is called structured NAP citation because we have different options. Different option for name, another option for the street, another option for the building, another option for the city, for zips, for state, for country, different phone number, different options were there, right? So that is why this is called structured NAP citation. We used to, I showed you unstructured NAP citation on the classified tutorial where I told you to put the NAP information on the same position. On the classified ad description field, we used to put the NAP citation, enter NAP, name, address, phone number of the business. So that is why that particular thing is called unstructured NAP, because we are not using different options. There is no other phone number option, there is no street option, there is no name option, building option, city option. All the details we used to put on a same field, ad description field. That is why that is called unstructured NAP. And here we created this structured NAP citation and a link. So once I verify here, my business will be immediately live on justdial.com. All the information will be live, and after that you may upload couple of pictures. You can see after you verify, you have this upload video logo pictures option, so you can upload your company logo, some of the pictures of your company, or if you have any video, you can upload that on justdial.com. So these are the way you have to create a business listing on a site like justdial.com. So you go to any website that can be for any location. Maybe you have a client in Australia and they are also doing the same thing, cleaning business. So you have to find out a business listing site from Australia. If your client is from Australia and if you are submitting their business information on an Indian business listing site, that is not going to work. If your client is in Australia and if you are doing a business listing for their company on a local business listing site, it has to be local website, some website from Australia. There can be many local business listing site which are global. Maybe Foursquare is a global international site. So you can be from anywhere, you can use foursquare.com. Some of the sites can be nationalized, means local business listing site like JustDial. JustDial is only available in India. Trade India, it's only available in India. And remember this is important. Means if you mix between cities or mix between countries, then it would be difficult. And your NAP citations should be 100% same. This is very important for local search engine optimization. Maybe you are getting a backlink. So that is one thing for regular optimization, right? So backlink is important for regular optimization that will help you in organic ranking. But if you want to rank your business, rank your website on local box, then local optimization is also important. And that is very competitive today. So if you are into a local business industry, or maybe your client is working in a local business industry, still first you see their country where they are working. You have to find out a business listing site from that country, open that website, and then there you have to register their business information, and you can build their NAP citation as well as you can build a link back to their site. That is how you have to work. So here I'm going to show you another site. I will show you, say, for silex.in. This is another Indian site. You can you can copy this domain, you can move to Google, search with the domain. It should rank on the first position. So it's ranking on the first position. There is no problem with the site. Most probably there is no problem with the site, www.silex.in. and you move to Open Site Explorer, put silence.in and search whether the domain authority is more than 40 or not. It's coming 29, it's less than 40. So skip this site. We may not build a link from here, but you have to remember one thing, that local SEO is very important. Now for local SEO, these websites are very important. You may not have a long list of local business listing site, particularly for a country. So in that way, if you get a website like this, 29 domain authority, 2 spam score, but the site is coming on the first position, then you can build a link here, because there are not that much local business listing site for a country. Maybe hundreds, or maybe more than maybe 120 or 130 maximum you would get for a country. So in that way, you may try to get a link from here, you try to get a citation, app citation from here. So but yeah, definitely 40, if you get more than 40, that is very good. If you are not finding 40, if you see that the site is coming on first position, domain authority spam score is less than 4, then you can try to get a link from a site like this. So I'm moving to the site, and let's see how it works. It's similar like justdial.com. We would be able to build our NAP citation, structured NAP citation, and we would be able to build a link for our site. So NAP citation will help us in local SEO, and a regular link will help us in organic SEO. So this is the site. As you can see, there is an option for register, sign in. So we have to register our business here. And this site is for India. You can see all the Indian cities are here, and those are all Indian cities. So this particular website cannot be used for maybe one Australian site. If you want to use Australia, you have to go there. See, silex.com.au is there. If your client is from maybe from Italy, you have to move to this silex.it. So if your client is from anywhere, you have to register their business from that location. Country specific business listing site is very important. So we can move here on top of the page, and this is for India, Silex for India. So we can click here on register. We want to register our business information on this site. So click on this register button. You will be taken to this page, and there you have to put your business information. So Silex community business directory, we want to use business directory here, not the community. So click here on register for business directory, and you will be taken to this page where you have to search with the company name. So there, check your company name here. So company name is Clean Master. So we are putting the same thing here, Clean Master, and you can put the city same. Again, I'm telling, the name should be same, company name, city name should be same, which we have mentioned on GMB. Don't change anything. Company website, same, HTTP or HTTPS, www or non-w. And there should be the same thing, same version which your site is opening with. And put the website here, cleanmaster.in. This can be the website. Check name. So, click here, and if there is any company with the same name, they may show you this here. There is no company with this name on our database, so you have this option. Even if you see any companies coming here, you would have this option, add company. So click on that, click on add company option. You will be taken to the page, next page, and there you have to put all the business information. So we could not, it's saying that we could not retrieve the info from our from your website. Please try again, fill in the data manually. So this website is an example site we are using, right? So this may or may not exist, so we do not know. Most probably that site is not existing. So they are telling us to put all the information manually. So no problem, we can do that. We have to put a password here. Say for we are putting a password like anything. So maybe this is the password. This is not important. It's not present on GMB. So we may skip this option. This is not mandatory also. We have to put the address. You see, this is the street address. So the same street address which you have mentioned on GMB, exactly same thing you have to mention here. So maybe we have mentioned MG Road. So we can mention the MG Road here. Detail address, here we have to put all the business building name and all. So same thing we have to put. Don't change anything. Next, city, we have already mentioned the city. Postal code, put the same postal code here. District is not important. See, district was not present on GMB, so we do not have to put the district here. State, the state from here, we are selecting Delhi. This is the state, right? So we have to select it's Delhi only. Delhi is not present here. Select UP. Yeah, that's a problem. See, in this case we do not have Delhi as a state here, so in that case we are selecting UP here, so it's not right, but we do not have any option. So this is what we selected here. Next one is business email address. Put the same email ID. Put the phone number. Again, this is another thing you have to remember, that the phone number should be the same phone number which you have mentioned on GMB. So here we are putting the same phone number. You can put the department name, that is not required. Select fax number. Again, that is not much important. Select main fax number. Those are not even PO box number. Don't put any PO box number here. That is one thing you must ignore. You cannot put your PO box number anywhere when you are doing local business, local SEO. PO box is very negative thing for local SEO. Never put your PO box information anywhere. So what we have done here, we have mentioned our website. This is the company name. We have mentioned the password. We have put the street address, the building details. City, zip code, and the state. State is not present. Delhi state is not present. So we mentioned Uttar Pradesh. This is a problem, but we do not have any other option. Company website, put the same website, put the email ID, official email ID, put the phone number, same phone number on GMB. We have mentioned here the same phone number. We are not going to put any other phone number here. As I told, alternate numbers are not important. And finally, once you are done here, you select I agree to Silex, and don't select this type of, otherwise you will get lots of emails. You can put the captcha here. And finally, the next step, click here on next step, you'll be taken to the next page, and there you have to put a couple of other details. They're asking you for search terms separated by commas, 1000 characters maximum. We can put some of the keywords here. Search term means keywords. So maybe cleaning services, this is a global keyword we are putting. We can put a local keyword, say for cleaning services in Delhi, home cleaning, like this. We can put different keywords here separated by comma, and it's a short description. Now this short description is the meta description. It's going to be the meta description. It's 1000 characters, but never put more than 150 characters here. It's going to be a meta description for the page. So you know the meta description length is 150 including everything. So put a meta description about this. This is going to be a company page. CleanMaster will have a page on silex.in. That page meta description you are going to put here. So you can put maybe the clean master. A professional cleaning service company in Delhi offering all home, or you can put corporate before corporate and home cleaning services. Affordable price range, something like this would be fine. It should not go more than 150 characters. And after that we have a long description option. So here we have to put a brief about our company. We have 2000 characters length here limitation, so it can be say for maybe 400 words or something, that would be around 2000 characters. So you have to write a content, maybe 300 or 350 words content you have to write and paste it here. Same thing, you have to put your brief about your company. You have to put a list. You have to create a list. What are the services you are offering? You can brief all those services with one or two sentences. And you can put all your means maybe industry associations, your maybe some of your recommendations, or maybe whatever awards you have received so far. So you can put all those information, and at the end of this long description option, you always put your NAP information. Open the notepad which you have saved during GMB. Open that notepad, copy the NAP information and paste it here. Never type the NAP information. That is what I'm telling again and again, because this is very important. Your NAP should be 100% consistent everywhere over internet. The same exact same thing should be present, which you have mentioned on GMB. Exactly same NAP information should be present all over the internet. So it cannot be deviate from GMB. So copy the NAP information, paste it here. And finally, that would be the long description. Your company brief about the company, brief about your different services, a list about all the services, then brief all those services one by one, maybe two or three sentences for each service, and put some industry association brief, some award briefs, and finally you have to put the NAP. Once you are done here, you have to click here on this. You can actually put the same information here, when you were closed, when you were open, all those stuffs. So definitely we are open on Monday. We can actually put the timing here from 10 in the morning till 6 in the evening we are open. So you can put the same. So just do the same thing here, apply to all. It will be applied to all. So if you come at the bottom, it's already applied. Now on Saturday also we are open. So from 10 to 2, right? So you can select 2 from here. And finally, please check this box. If you operate or on split shift, such as 9 or like this, these are good for BPO companies or like that similar. Appointments, these are not very much important. These are not present on GMB. So this is important because this is present on GMB. So you have to put the same information here. Once you are done with all those details, you have to click here on submit, save. Definitely they will send you an email with a link. You have to click on that link, and finally you have to activate. They may send you an SMS also with a code, just like JustDial. You can use that particular code to activate this profile. So once your profile is activated, they may take this information on moderation first. Once it is moderated, once it is approved, you will see that you have a company page, silex.in/ maybe clean master, similar, same or similar like that. So on that page information, you would be able to see all the company information you have mentioned here. All those things will be listed there, with all your structured NAP citation, plus with a backlink to your site. So in this way, you can put, you can create structured NAP citation for your business, and you can create a business backlink, a inbound backlink for your website. So this is how you have to use these type of websites for NAP citation building plus backlink building. Now I want to show you how to find, how you can find a website. Say for you have a client from UK. Now I want to see all the list, business listing sites from UK. So how to find that? So it's very easy. We can put the same thing, Hypier business listing sites UK site, search with this, and you can see there are lots of leads are there. List, this is one list, 70 plus business listing sites, Hypier local business. This is most probably for UK, and this is another top 50 business listing site UK, top 40 business listing sites UK. So these are all, you can use these websites to get a required list, and you can use that for your business listing, link building, and citation building purpose. So here maybe top 100 free Hypier UK business directory submission sites. So we can click this, and there will be a list of business listing sites which are primarily built for UK. We can use this list, we can check those domain. PageRank is not anymore relevant today. Yale.com, you can just copy this from here, go to Google first, go to Google, search with the domain. Yell, search with that, it should come on the first position. Yale.com, it's coming on the first position, and then you move to Open Site Explorer. Site is opening with www. Move to Open Site Explorer, and again you search with Yale.com, and check their domain authority and spam score. So domain authority is very high, spam score is 3. So we can build a link here on Yale.com. We can go to the site, and we can open the site. So this site is primarily built for UK. So you can see this site and get your business listed on Yale.com for free. So submit details. You would always see this type of buttons or links if you move to a directory, business directory sites. So submit your details, click there. If you have a client from UK, they are doing their business in UK, so you have to submit their business information, their NAP information on a UK directory, not on any other country directories. So this is the UK directory. You can see this is UK's leading online business directory. So you have to post all the business information here. So business name, phone number, website, business classification means start typing, select the business most appropriate from the list. So it's basically that category they are asking for. So you have to put the category, you have to select from the list, and see their number on which is your business, where is your business located. You can put the number, you can put the postcode. You have this option, enter manually, first name, last name. These are all email address, my business, operational hours. So once you are done here, you have to submit the business information. So the exact same thing, there is no difference as such, but yeah, you have to find out a list like this, and after that you can use this site, all those sites for UK business listing sites, as a UK business listing sites. So you have to search with this kind of keyword, Hypier business listing site in UK. Just mention the country you are looking for, search on Google, and you will get a list of websites for that country, list of business listing sites for that country. You do the analysis yourself, whether the site is coming on first position for the domain search, whether it's having a good domain authority, less spam score. You have to check all those stuffs, and then you open the website. If everything is means fine, if all the parameters are working fine, then you open the site on a browser and build the NAP citation for your client or for your business, and get a link back to your site from that business listing site. So you can see Yelp.com, all those websites are there. These are all UK business listing sites. So you have to just search on Google and you can find a list like this. So this is how you have to use GMB. This is how you have to use local business listing sites. So the only thing you have to remember when you are using local business listing sites for citation building, that you should always maintain the same citation, same NAP citation. Whatever you have posted on GMB, exact same NAP citation you have to post on all other business listing site for a company. So never make anything different. And if you can make it consistent, if you can create maybe 40 or 50 or 60 business listing consistent NAP information, then you can rank on local SEO box, local box. So local business listing site will help you in local SEO using citation, NAP citation, and local listing sites will also help you in organic SEO, organic ranking with backlinks. So this is why local business listing is very important, very crucial. You should do this for your company. Maybe 10-20% links from local business listing sites are good. If you have 100 total backlinks, 10% or 20% local business listing links are good for your site. And this is how you have to use local listing sites. This is how you have to build links from local listing sites, and you have to get a consistent NAP citation from local listing sites. And this will help you in local SEO as well as organic SEO.